Reading Landscape is a mixed media installation done by Xu Bin. Xu is an artist from China, and he is known for working with Chinese calligraphy character, pictographic script, and symbol. His works cross the boundary of different languages and even blur the borderline between text and painting. These are his famous creative elements in his works, and these characteristics are also there in the work of Reading Landscape. She is being literal but also original to illustrate a landscape view with Chinese characters in this work. Reading Landscape is composed of over 1,000 small pictographic characters. These pictographic characters represent all different details from a landscape view to depict nature, animals, and weather. She uses each symbol repeatedly over and over again to describe the actual landscape scene. They are symbols to represent nature, such as grass, flower, leaf, wood, forest, stone, earth, and water. These symbols all have different color, and each piece of the same symbol does not have the exact same color either. For instance, the grass, leaf, and forest symbols are colored in a variety of tints of green. The wood and earth symbols are brown. The stone symbols are light gray and dark gray. The water symbols are white. In the contrast, the flower symbols are in bright, rich red or yellow, which stand up the most from all other natural colors. There are also pictographic characters for weather and animals, such as cloud, rain, thunder, bird, cow, deer, fish, and boat. These symbols most are in their representational colors, but she also makes some color choices to let an object different from its surroundings. For example, the fish character is in vibrant red color in the river that is composed of white water symbols, so it can capture the audience's attention immediately. Moreover, these symbols are not only different by their color, their sizes and angles vary as well. As an illustration, the bird symbols are arranged in a queue from a corner of the room, fly into the center of the room. The bird symbols are gradually enlarged as they fly closer into the middle of the scene, which is beautifully vivid and true to reality. Although these pictographic characters are small, they form a large image when they are put together. These characters are three-dimensional. They are made with acrylic, which adds thickness and volume to them. These characters go across and cover the floor and ceiling of the exhibition room. She thoughtfully creates pathways within Reading Landscape. It is like a landscape garden, and the audience can walk along the river or wander in the forest. It is stunning to see how these symbols fill the whole space and create a landscape scene that the audience can actually walk in and enjoy. She also uses these symbols to interact with the other two artworks that hang next to Reading Landscape. One of them looks like a traditional Chinese painting of a mountain. This mountain is formed by many giant storms. She extends this beautiful mountain painting outside of its frame by arranging stone, wood, cloud, and other symbols in different colors and sizes around this painting. She stays true to the painting and does not add any art elements to this composition. He simply widens and illustrates the scenes that the canvas is not able to cover due to its size. Similarly, she also expands the view of the other artwork to go beyond its canvas. This other artwork is a photograph of a white birch forest and a pond underneath it. On the bottom half of the image, there are inclined white birches and their branches in the pond. She does not only put the symbols of forest, wood and stone around this photo, but he also plays with different angles of the symbols. She neatly put crowded characters of forest and wood around the upper half of the photo to show the luxuriance of the forest. Additionally, on the space around the pond, he arranges and turns the wood character leaning toward the pond. He even thoughtfully designs the wood characters inclined into different angles to create a realistic view according to the original image. She creatively worked with the ancient Chinese pictographic script to literally spell the landscape scene out. When there is a mountain, he puts the symbol of mountain there. When there is water, he puts the symbols of water there. She plays with the characteristic of realism and representationalism in this work. This artwork also lets the Chinese speakers get to know this language again in a different way and concept. Xu's artwork reflects the relationship between nature and the Chinese language of how the ancient Chinese people designed the character system realistically to Hua Leixin. The pictographic scripts recall the touching emotions when the ancestors touch the water with their lips or witness the light of the fire for the first time. She carries on these touching moments and spreads them across beyond the boundary of cultures and languages. Even the people who do not know Chinese can also enjoy reading landscape and be touched by it.